Everybody, welcome today to the Debby Campbell Goodtime Show. And boy, have we got a great guest for you today. He's with a musical group, and this group in 1979, they had the Academy of Country Music's Vocal Group of the Year, and they also had the Album of the Year. And in 1971, 75, and 77, they had Grammys for the Best Gospel Contemporary Christian Music Performance. And the list goes on. I mean, 1978, Country Music Award Vocal Group of the Year. 1978, Grammy again, Best Gospel Performance. 1985, American Music Award Favorite Country Band. And then into the 2015, the Dove Awards for Country Recorded Song of the Year, and also Bluegrass Recorded Song of the Year in 2016. But without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my very special guest and friend, Joe Bonsall from the Oak Ridge Boys. Hi, Joe.
Hello, Deb.
Oh my gosh, so happy to see you. It's been a long time.
It really does seem like it's been a long time since we used to be together more often.
Exactly. I mean, oh my gosh, we all lived together practically at that point, you know.
We really did. We did a lot of shows with Glen back in the day, and you were always there and always a big part of it. And we had a lot of fun.
We did. We had so much fun. So, Joe, I've learned a lot about you. It's really funny. When we first were performing with y'all in Branson, I actually had the Oak Ridge Boys autobiography. And so I read that. And I mean, the history of all of that, you know, it told me a lot about y'all. But I just started when I was going through your bio that you started singing at 4 years old.
Yeah, I actually did. My mother always encouraged me to sing, and I grew up in a neighborhood in Philadelphia, you know, in a row house. And my mother would always have the neighbors over, and you know, I always talk about how in life everything you do is a little pebble, a little stone that becomes the mountain that is you.
Right.
Well, every time my mother ever said, Joey, get up and sing one for the neighbors. And she taught me songs to sing, and I'd get up and sing some gospel song or some country song that she loved, like Walking the Floor Over You or something. And I'd sing for the neighbors, and the neighbors always seemed to enjoy it.
And now, did they tip you?
No.
No tips, huh?
Church. And then
maybe they were tipping mom.
Yeah, she entered me in a contest when I was 4 years old.
Oh, my gosh.
It was called the Horn and Hard Art Talent Hour. And it was on TV in Philly, down at Channel 10 in Philadelphia.
Oh, my goodness.
And, of course, I didn't win, but it was kind of a cool experience to be 4 years old and sing on television.
Of course. Yeah, absolutely. And, of course, and if it was in Philadelphia, you're obviously a Philadelphia Eagles fan.
Yeah. I love my Eagles. Yeah. I really do. That Super Bowl win a couple of years ago was glorious.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, my friend Jeremy, my son, my youngest, he had a roommate in L.A., and he's from Philly. Mm-hmm. And, oh, my gosh. Philadelphia Eagles, everything, you know, I mean, and he gets so upset.
You know? I'm a little torn now because, you know, all these years the Titans have been here in Nashville. I have season tickets. I just love the NFL. I can't believe
that
we play NFL football downtown Nashville. So I go to as many games as I can, and I love the Titans. But when the Titans play the Eagles, I got to admit, I'm a little torn.
Right. Oh, I bet you are. Oh, my gosh. And yeah, I read that you had season tickets. That's pretty cool. So, Joe, the Oak Ridge Boys. You joined them in 1973.
Yes, ma'am.
Yep. And that was just prior before they arrived into the country music scene because they were more Southern gospel.
Yeah, the group was Southern gospel when I joined all the way. And but, you know, we were a real progressive gospel group, man. I mean, you know, we didn't dress alike. We had long hair. We were the first guys in Southern gospel to hire a band and a rock and roll drummer. And we had a lot of people just upset with us. And we kept trying to progress, and for several years, I mean, we didn't go to bed as a gospel act and wake up as a hit-making future Hall of Fame country act. It didn't happen. Right. But we had all those gray years, but in 77, when Y'all Come Back Saloon hit, away we went. So we had to be patient there for a lot of years, though.
Yeah, you had a lot of awards back then. I mean, oh my gosh, the Country Music Award, what was it, Album of the Year, Vocal Group of the Year. I mean, you just, and then all those Dove Awards, but wait. 2015. Now that was pretty special.
Well, the most amazing thing that could happen, and to be in the Country Music Hall of Fame with people like Glen, You know, I don't know that there's anything that we have ever done that was more moving or more important to us.
Right.
Was
it like at the Country Music Awards where they announced it? I don't remember in 2015 where it was that
time. They did it different there for about the last 6-7 years. They kind of announced it in June, who's going to be in.
Right.
And then November.
So happy to be able to be the one to induct you into the Hall of Fame.
So thank you very much. I know some of you feel like, well, how the hell did he get in here? But thank y'all. I love you. I wouldn't take nothing for this moment right now. Thank you so much.
End of October, they have the what they call the medallion ceremony, where you're actually inducted into the hall and they unveil, you know, the big plaque with your faces on it and everything. And everybody always laughs because nobody really looks like themselves on those things. But
right.
I thought they did pretty good with us.
Yeah, I went to that one with Dad. You know, he was inducted in 2005. And that was in New York that we went. And
right.
I went to the medallion ceremony with Dad. In fact, I have Dad's medallion.
Wow. Wow, that's something. Yeah. But, you know, to all of a sudden be there, you know, with Johnny Cash and Campbell, I mean, that's just something that just lasts forever. I mean, you know, when we're done singing, we'll still be in the Hall of Fame.
Can you remember a little bit of what you wrote that day when you went in there?
Well, yes. I did you read that piece I wrote?
I did. I have it sitting right here in front of me. It was absolutely
beautiful. About sitting on the floor of the rotunda?
Oh, my gosh. I got tears. I mean, Sandy sent it to me, and it just, oh, my gosh, so beautiful. You know, and then when I read that, and then I read that you write books, I mean, no mm-hmm. wonder this was so eloquently written, you know? I mean, that was so special. That was a really, is that somewhere where fans can get on and read that you wrote that?
I think it's on my website, josephsbonsall.com, and under other writings, I think you might could find it there. It's probably the only place. I think some periodicals and stuff put it out way back then when I wrote it.
I mean, I'll put that in the credits, you know, down your website and everything that fans can go to, because I think that's something beautiful to see.
Well, it was such a cool early morning, and I sat in there all by myself, and the sun was coming up, and you know how the rotunda is there. The sun comes up and shines. It like shines in there almost like God's blessing everybody on the wall, you know.
Right.
It just was an amazing thing to realize that this little kid from Philadelphia, who's had an incredible career with the Oak Ridge Boys. A lot of good things have happened to us over the years. You know, I know that. But to be on that wall and that rotunda, I don't know that it gets any more special, Deb.
Right. I know. That's just the ultimate gratification in your heart that of what you love to do. I mean, oh, my God. And all these books you've written. Tell me about the Molly books.
Well, the Molly books are my first books I wrote. They were a children's book series that were published by Ideals Children's Books based on my cats. It's a book about talking cats. I mean, you know, that's about what it is.
And you have cats.
I always have cats. Yes, we are cat people. We have cats. In fact,
my mom was a cat people, cat person, I should say.
In fact, I just finished what may be a book like that. I haven't written children's books in years. I've written a couple regular books, but we just lost a 22-year-old little girl kitty here that just like lit up our lives. And her name was Sally Ann, and I just finished writing a book called Sally Ann. I don't know if it'll be published or not, but we'll have to see.
Oh, that's awesome.
Illustrated, but yeah. But the biggest seller I had was G.I. Joe and Lily.
I was just going to ask you about that. That's based on your mom and dad, right?
My mom and dad were both World War II veterans, and daddy was a hero at D-Day. Mom was the whack that met him when he came home, and they married, and, you know, he had a stroke at age 39.
Wow. And did he pass away then?
No, he didn't pass away till age 75.
Wow.
And my mother looked after him all those years. It's a really cool book about love and about patriotism. And it was a bestseller. And
right.
I felt really good about the fact that I got to honor my parents. A lot of people don't get to do that.
Right. That's amazing. And then you also, is this book released yet? I mean, I think it is. On the Road with the Oak Ridge Boys. Have you finished?
Yes, it's been out for a couple of years. Yes, ma'am. That is a total book on this group. I make you a fly on the wall in our world. How have we done what we've done? How do we do what we do?
Right.
How do we get from point A to B to C to D? And you're a fly on the wall. CMT.com called it the best behind-the-scenes music book written in the last 25 years.
Oh, my God. That's awesome. Now, that's not the coffee table book. Is that the coffee table
book? Oh, that's an American Journey. In fact, I figured I wrote all there was to write about the Oak Ridge Boys in that book. It was a big coffee table book. I wrote all the text. And I tried to do that very same thing. And a couple years later, when I was offered this thing, they wanted a book on the Oak Ridge Boys, based on road life, road stories, that kind of thing. And I thought to myself, man, I think I've done this. But yet, I came up with a new way and a new way to do it, and with a lot of new stuff and a lot of new angles. You know, it's what you do when you've got a project. You got to come up with something new and different and fresh. And On the Road with the Oak Ridge Boys is a pretty cool read. I'm not so sure it's not the best thing I've done.
I'm going to have to get that. That sounds like an amazing book that I'd like to read.
Oh, I know you will.
I felt like I was on the road with the Oak Ridge Boys. My kids felt like they were on the road with the Oak Ridge Boys. they still talk about that ping pong table, you know? I mean.
Oh, my gosh, the old ping pong table.
We
were always playing.
Yeah, remember this, Joe? Of course, that's one of my favorite moments, you know, when I came out like Elvira.
Uh-huh.
And then, of course, I had to, I've never met William Lee, but I have this picture, God rest Steve's soul, but that was so much fun times for everybody. What year did you guys start playing in Branson?
I know that way before I even joined the group, the Oak Ridge Boys played at Shepherd of the Hills Farms there in the old,
really?
Old gospel
days. So that would be the early 70s?
Yeah, or late 60s.
Really? Probably. Wow.
Yeah. Because, you know, Dwayne Allen's been here since 1966, and William Lee Golden first joined in 65.
Wow.
I joined in 73, and Richard joined the year before me. That makes me the new guy.
Yeah.
I'm still the new guy.
But you're like the spokesman of everybody, though.
Yeah, sometimes.
Yeah, pretty much. So,
pretty much.
So Roy Clark, I think he was probably like the first that had a theater there in 1987. That's about the time, I guess, that it was really started booming. And then you guys were like a staple there almost. I mean.
Yeah, well, we would come in there and play. We still do. We still play a handful of dates every year in there. But I'll tell you, when they first opened up that big grand palace at the time, boy, that was the showplace of the Midwest.
I know it. That was
big theater, seated 4,000, and they brought the Oak Ridge Boys and Glen Campbell in to play it together.
I know.
Gosh, that was exciting. So much fun.
It was fun. Now, did you ever play with Louise Mandrell? Because she was the queen, so it was either Dad and somebody or Louise and somebody.
Oh yeah, we were there. We were there from time to time with Louise. We were there more with Glenn.
Right.
But we played there with Louise as well. And then after a while, then we started coming in there and just playing it on our own for a long time.
Right.
And now they're making an aquarium out of it. Did you know that?
Out of the Grand Palace?
Yes.
No, I had no idea.
It's been sitting there full of spiders for about 6-7 years now.
Right.
And I guess somebody bought it. And I went down there to look because I'd heard they were making an aquarium out of it. I don't think it's open yet. But man, I mean, it's supposed to be like one of the top aquariums like in the country. So this whole palace that we all used to play in, you're going to be able to
acoustics.
Get there and see fish.
Yeah, the best acoustics ever. Oh my gosh. Well, then Dad's theater had great acoustics too.
Oh, it did. And you know, then we eventually ended up playing there all the time.
Exactly. Yeah. And didn't that become your theater?
It became our theater for a couple of years. At least we had our name on it.
Right.
We didn't own it, but it was an Oak Ridge Boy Theater. It was the very same place, Glen Campbell. Right. Wasn't it the Mel Tillis even before that?
No, Mills was the other one. Wasn't Mel? They built Dad's for him. Mills was at the old Will Rogers Theater.
That's right. You're right.
It was right next door. Yeah, yeah. Well,
we go in there now. We play for the people that owned the Oak Ridge Boy Theater that was Glenn's Theater. Where it's we play the Mansion now, the Mansion Theater.
And they who is that's not the Halls.
No, the Halls are long gone. It's Wilhite.
Oh, the Wilhite, really? Now, some of those people sing, don't they? The Wilhites, I think.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, they do. That's right, yeah.
They do. They have singing group. In fact, for a long time, we'd play there at night, and their group played in the afternoon. It got to be kind of sad, though, because they didn't have anybody there.
Oh, jeez. Not for your show.
No, for theirs.
Right. Oh, wow. Well, because everybody's waiting up for the nighttime. Yeah.
They quit doing that. But, you know, that's the way it goes sometimes. But we still go in there and play. We've got dates booked there this year in September, October, and November, I hope.
Oh, I know. It's just, what's going to happen, Joe? I mean, oh, my gosh.
You know, it's the uncertainty, Deborah, that is so hard to deal with because we don't know. I mean, we had all of our dates. All of a sudden, we're doing a big show on March 14th. In South Carolina, got on the bus and came home, not realizing that we would not be taking off again, that all our dates would cancel or postpone.
Right.
And we have not done a show since March 14th. And I doubt very much we're going to be doing any shows in June or July.
Yeah.
So now starting in August, our date book is full.
Wow.
If this thing keeps coming back and we can go do shows, the Oak Ridge Boys may survive this thing if we can claw our way through till August.
Yes.
But if the whole year goes away, I don't know, we may have to shut it all down like a lot of people are going to have to do and just wait till that time comes when we can do it again, you know?
Exactly.
Yes. So it's been tough on everybody, but it's really tough on all of us because we're like non-essential people and we've been shut down. They flipped the switch. I don't care if you're AC/DC or Bon Jovi or the Blackwood Brothers Quartet or the Oak Ridge Boys. You're shut down. You're home.
Yeah.
And it's kind of hard to deal with, to be honest.
It is. And this is great. This is a great thing that people can get on the computers and talk to each other and
Yes. Do
music if they want, you know. You want to play the banjo for us? You've been playing the banjo. Oh my God, that's amazing.
Yeah, I've been picking on the instrument for a long time. I really should be better, to be honest.
Yeah.
But there's no professional banjo players in any danger for me.
I mean, I should have asked you if you wanted to play it before I just threw that out at you. I mean, that'd be fun to hear you do it.
The banjo is not nearby, and I'm holding this iPad. I don't think I can do both of them.
Oh, you're on an iPad. That's funny. And you have a part. You step on one of your albums. You have the lead playing the banjo, don't you? I think I read
I've played on a couple of things that we've done, but they were simple things. I didn't do anything real difficult.
Yeah, but it's still fun. I mean, it's gratifying to do that, you know?
Well, it's fun for me, Deborah, because I never played an instrument of any kind, you know? I've played a little piano over the years, but nothing good. And I took up banjo several years ago because I just liked the sound of it. I thought it was exciting. And it's a fun thing to do when you're – it's kind of fun just to get into the music and pick it on your own, you know, not having to worry about picking every note right or being on stage or something. It's just kind of fun to sit on the porch and play it loud. The coyotes don't seem to mind.
Yeah, Ashley's a good little banjo player.
Oh, she's a hero.
Yeah, she's amazing. She can play that thing, man.
She sure can. I'll tell you, she's a banjo hero to me. Give her my best, please.
Yeah, that's great.
Tell her I need some lessons.
Oh, okay. All right, we'll work on that. I'm sure she'd be, well, you could social distance and get lessons right now, I'm sure.
I think, yeah.
That's so cool. So did you plug in? You're not plugging in the banjo then?
Oh, no.
Just plugging in the iPad.
Just unplugged in.
So what are all the guys doing? Have they been staying safe?
Everybody in our whole, around our campfire is fine. Everybody's safe. Everybody's healthy. Everybody's wanting to get back on the road and get back to singing. Yeah. But, you know, at the same time, you know, it's been a blessing to be home. I mean,
everybody's getting back to nature.
We're a hardworking group, right? And it's nice to be back in nature. It's great to spend time with your family. In my case, with my wife, Mary, who's sitting right in front of me right now.
Hi, Mary.
Hi, Mary.
Hi.
From Debby Campbell. But, you know, to be with the kids and the grandkids and to be home a lot, it's been a unique blessing in itself, too. It gives you time to kind of fuel up and to change your perspective a little bit, maybe, and appreciate the good things in life. You know, God's been good to us. He's blessed us. Our career is over, I guess it's over. We're the old guys. Everybody's saying, hey, man, when are you guys going to retire? And the answer is why retire? But God will tell us when. Well,
right.
We're listening.
I think God told a lot of people to retire right now with this epidemic that's going on. I think he's trying to get this world back to the basics starting, you know, I went to buy bird seed because I got birds that I got babies laying babies in my planters. And so I want to feed the mama and everything and go to the bird store and there's no more feed because it's sold out because everybody's back looking at nature and enjoying flowers and planting and gardening and, you know, and it's kind of rough for people like us that are used to being on the go all the time. But then
I have to admit, I've enjoyed being home. I've always enjoyed coming home. You know, I've been very blessed, like I say, and I've always enjoyed going out to sing and I've always enjoyed coming home. Well, right now the balance is switched to home and which is unique for us, but you know, there'll come a time, I think, when we'll get back out there and we'll be singing. And I think everything's coming back to normal, slow but sure. So we'll see what happens. We've got to be prayerful and optimistic.
I'm sure the grandkids have been happy and your kids, you know.
I've had a good time. In fact, the grandkids. I got a great-grandson now, too.
I have a 3-year-old great-granddaughter, Joe. Can you believe that? She's
mine's 3.
Is he? When's his birthday?
February 21st.
Okay, so he is... Mine will be 4 in January. So she's okay. A month older.
They're close.
And hers is January, I think it's the 21st. That's so crazy. Yeah. But they're blessings.
So Debby Campbell now has a great grand.
I know. It's really funny, Joe, because when I became a grandma at 40, Dad became a great grandpa at 60. So then I became a great grandma at 60, and Dad became a great grandpa at 80. So wow. It was like just spread like that. Yeah. So he was able, in fact, I have a 5-generation picture that I was able to get before Dad passed away.
I have a 5-generation picture of my wife and her mom and her daughter and granddaughter and great-grandson. Yes, I have a 5-generation.
Isn't that amazing? Did you have it blown up really big?
No, not yet, but we have them. We definitely have them.
That is amazing. Those are such treasures because family is everything. Yes.
That is exactly the word. It's a treasure. Yep.
I know. And I thought, boy, by the time I'm 80, am I going to be a great, Well, God willing, I will, but that's funny. So I know Dwayne doesn't do Zoom. And I mean, that would have been so much fun to have all 4 of you on. But Kathy told me that Dwayne doesn't do Zoom. And she just said, Joe would love to do it. So I'm like, okay, I'll love to talk to Joe.
Well, thank you, Deborah. And I know all the guys have so much love and respect for you and your family. I know I can easily bring regards and love from Dwayne and William Lee and Richard. Yeah. And we've got a lot of great memories together with you, with your dad. And I was looking just the other day, I came across the video from Minnie Pearl's Christmas party, CBS Christmas party on YouTube. Uh-huh. And Glenn and us are in that thing together, and it's really fun. We have a lot of great memories with Glenn.
Oh my gosh, I bet that was funny. Yeah, I'd love. It's a picture you said. I'd love to see it. That's awesome.
And they'll be carrying their torches when they come. When they come,
we'll be here.
We all will greet them. We'll greet them when they come. We're here to meet and greet them when they come.
We'll be there to meet them.
Meet them when they come.
When they come,
we will greet them. Greet them when they come. We will celebrate together when they come.
Awesome. So we don't know about going. Is Ronnie Fairchild still with y'all?
Yes, he is. He's been playing with us for over 40 years.
Wow. And I know, was William Lee's son with y'all? Is that, I don't know who the back of the band is now.
Right. He's not with us now. He's out doing solo work now. Chris Golden is. He's doing a lot of Christian solo work, and he's doing real well.
Oh, nice. And I know Richard Tracy, who used to be Dad's theater manager, has Richard's granddaughter.
Yes, indeed. And she's all grown up now too. She's in high school. She's an athlete. She's doing great. And we see them every once in a while in Branson.
Oh, that is so awesome.
Yeah.
Gosh. So anything else you want to talk about, Mr. Bonsall? You got
no,
anything
man, I'm good. Plug? I'm good. We're good. We're hoping to record a new album here in the new future. And we're gathering up some new music to go in the studio, and that'll be fun and refreshing for us. Right. And we're hopefully going to get back out on the road, and hopefully we're going to be allowed to start playing music again. That's the main thing right now. Yeah, everybody stay healthy, stay strong.
Right.
Like I said, stay prayerful, stay optimistic.
Absolutely.
And let's try to, let the uncertainty wane away a little bit here, and let's get back to music.
Right. Right now we're taking time to smell the roses.
Yeah. And it's a good smell.
So hopefully you'll come to Phoenix.
Well, we had Phoenix booked. It got changed. We were going to be coming to the Celebrity Theater there in Phoenix. It was booked in March.
Wow.
But we'll have to wait now. But we'll get back there. It'll be rebooked, I'm sure, if we all get back going again.
Yeah, that's awesome. Well, Joe, it was so wonderful to talk to you. You are such a sweetheart. I give my love to the guys. And and I'll look for you out on the road. I'm actually have 3 dates in August, but they're at wineries. And I guess if it's outdoors, they can social distance. I mean, they haven't canceled it yet. But anyway, I love you so much.
We hope to hang on till August, too. We love you, too, baby. Thank you so much. Like I said, nothing but
next
love.
Next time, you're going to play your banjo.
Okay, you got it.
All right. Love to you. Mwah.
Thank you. The Deb Campbell Goodtime Hour. How cool is that?
I love you, Joe Bonsall.
You too. Take care, Deb.
Right. Bye, honey. Bye. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for being here watching our show today. And we hope you enjoyed Joe Bonsall, the Oak Ridge Boys, and make sure you go out and get the new book, On the Road with the Oak Ridge Boys, that Joe Bonsall wrote. And tune in next time for another very special guest on the Debby Campbell Goodtime Show. Thank you all.